Manistambha, a pillar that is often constructed in front of every Jain temple all over the world. A pillar that depicts the column of honor and also cause someone entering a Samavasarana to shed their pride. In India, Jain temples are mainly situated in northern states like Bihar, Bengal, Orissa, Gujarat, Rajasthan, and in the states of Karnataka. Manastambhas of South India are monolithic structures. Monolithic Manastambhas started in the era of Ganga and Rashtrakuta. In Karnataka, Manastambhas have been situated in places like Shravanabelagola, Moodibitri, and many other places. In Tulu Nadu, total 21 Manastambhas are there. Among them, Manastambha of Alathangadi is well known for its design and uniqueness. Alathangadi is a small town in Beltangadi Taluk of Dakshina Kannada district. Ajila Jaina, the Bunt dynasty, ruled over the Alathangadi town. The family members of Ajila rulers are now taking the care of Alathangadi Aramane, built by Ramadevi in 14th century.
Jaina ಬಸದಿಗಳ ಮುಂದೆ ನಾವು ಬಹಳ ಎತ್ತರದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಕೆಲವು ತೀರ್ಥಂಕರ ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು ನಾಲ್ಕು ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಕಡೆ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ಕೋಣ ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳನ್ನು ಸಹ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇವಲ ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಮಿಸುವ ಕೆತ್ತನೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾತ್ರ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತೀರ್ಥಂಕರ ಮೂರ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಸಹ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒಂದು ಬಹಳ ದೂರದವರೆಗೆ ಬಸದಿಯ ಗುರುತು ಸಿಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಉದ್ದೇಶದ ಒಂದು. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು, ನಾವು ಬಸದಿಗೆ ಬರುವಾಗಲೇ ಆ ಪರಿಧಿಯ ನಂತರ ನಾವು ಬಸದಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಶುದ್ಧಾಚಾರದ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಈ ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭದ ನಂತರ ಬಸದಿಗೆ ಪರಿಧಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ಆ ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭ ನಿರ್ಮಿಸಿರ್ತಾರೆ.
ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಶ್ವನಾಥ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಬಸದಿ ಇನ್ ಅಲದಂಗಡಿ ಟೌನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅಜಿಲಾ ರೂಲರ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಅಲದಂಗಡಿ ಮಾನಸ್ತಂಭ is very well known among all the Manastambhas in the surrounding areas. Because of its neat and highly clear filigree work that indicates the excellence of artwork, this Manastambha is recorded in most of the books which refers the history of Alathangadi. Sri Chandranath Swami statue is placed on the top and faces all four directions. Alathangadi Manastambha stands on three layers of Shilapita with a height of 5 feet, and every layer emphasizes the beauty of Jainism. Inscription related to Uttara, Vajana, Bhutali, Alingapatti, Kapota, Antarika engraved on each layers of the Shilapita. The top portion of Manastambha has four hanging bells. The reason behind this style of architecture is the mystery of 14th century. Each layer of Manastambha proceeding towards the top has fine filigree work that look exuberant. According to the Ajila family, this Manastambha is widely recognized amongst all the Jain basadis in the way of neat and clear emphasis of designs, and is mentioned in so many historical textbooks. One of the book is Velur Ajila Rajavamsha, written by Umanath Shenoy, historian.
Manastambhas, they are three pillars without any extra additions to them. So even during annual festival, though nothing is attached to the manastambhas. And it is not necessary that all basadis must have manastambhas. We find manastambhas only in front of some very important Jaina temples in our district and elsewhere also. They are stambhas made out of stone, but we find three parts in a manastambha. One part is the pedestal or the pita where the stambha is erected. Second part is the shaft or the actual stambha. And third is the top portion that is called mukuta. So on the pedestal, the stambha is erected quite vertically in 90 degrees. And on this, we find there are many designs and figures of birds and animals, and also figures of some Tirthankaras and others. But most often, the figures of swans.
Like this, Tulu Nadu has various designed manastambhas. Some are looked after by families who are taking care of the monuments, and some are under the control of the government. It is a matter of pride that the state of Karnataka has grown legacy for having maximum ancient temples and strong precious history. It's our duty to safeguard it and keep it for the next generation. Manastambhas are unique in the terms of fine filigree work carved on them. It is very rare to find such architectural designs on the stone, since they are the epitome of Indian ancient architectural monument. They need to be preserved and protected for the posterity.